he gave his life to Christ 26th of August, after roaming here and there, 2022. And he shared his testimony of a changed life. And since then, God has kept him. What about a testimony? What the world of science is running helter-skelter. And because they have no solution, they are now looking for a way to eliminate it through bats, or somebody having an sickle cell, SS. And in one of the global crusades, showers of blessing to be specific, the genotype moved from SS to AA. It's only God that can do that. What about the sister who testified? From B negative, God moved her to B plus. What about the sister who gave birth to twins? It's only God that can do this. And that's why we still need to raise our voice to God in praise and worship, thanking him for all these great things he's doing. It's only God that can turn the heart of man, turn the challenges of people to become a testimony. Raise your voice to God in prayer. What about the healing of a husband, the child, and the wife? Three people in a family. As I say, blessed be the name of the Lord who has visited and he has redeemed his people. Praise him for the mighty visitation. Since GK began, it has been very wonderful. There's no GCK without a testimony. And they are increasing in dimensions. What has never been, we are seeing it in our days. In Jesus' name we pray. Want us to thank him for our Father in the Lord. He is carrying the gospel with greater strength, the horn of salvation with greater strength. And it has been very amazing. Each edition, there are spectacular testimonies. Converts coming in. For God's operation in him is worth praising God for. It's worth thanking God for. That God has given us hope through him. God has given the world hope through him. Each time you look at him, it's as if the strength is increasing. The testimonies are increasing. Let us raise our voice to God in prayer as we thank God for our Father in the Lord. The authority of God is increasing every GCK. The manifestation of God is increasing every GCK. Either spoken word or being present, dissenting everywhere. People watching online are testifying. People far away in Canada are testifying. In Europe testifying. In Russia testifying. Far away in Asia testifying. In the Caribbean, everywhere. God's word moving in strength through his life, through his ministration. And for every other vessel who have dedicated themselves to this cause of global crusade with our Father in the Lord, let's praise God for the commitments, the consecration, the prayers, the support. In Jesus' name we pray. And today is day two. We want to ask God that, God, what will come out from the mouth of your servant, our Father in the Lord? No power will challenge it. No power will challenge it. No authority all over the world will challenge it. It will get to every destination. It will get to every life with strength. Let us raise our voice to God in prayer. His spoken word as the scripture has confirmed, will not return void. It will return with testimony of salvation, of healing, of deliverance, of being set free from the hands of the wicked. In Jesus' name we pray. Since the world began, this is wonderful. I want to pray. Today is day two. All over the world, from South America to Caribbean, to North America, to Canada, to Europe, to Russia, to Asia, to the Pacific, to Africa, the whole of Africa, I want to ask God that, God, there will be a new experience today, a greater experience today. Let's raise our voice to God in prayer. All over the world, all over Africa, a new experience, day two experience, prevailing experience in South America, in the Caribbean, in North America, in Canada. Join us in prayers anywhere you are, in Europe, in Russia, in the Asian world, in the Middle East, in the islands spread all over the world, new experience. Day two, greater experience. They will experience His touch, everyone. They will experience a turning point. They will experience yieldedness. They will experience His miracles. In Jesus' name we pray. Want to pray for all languages all over the world, all tribes, colors, race, culture, ages, literate, illiterate, that the word of God will come with strength unto them today, day two. They may not have experienced anything before, but day two, God will prevail. God will prevail in every heart, in all languages, all over the world, all colors, all over the world. Starting from the Alpha location here, we raise our voice to God in prayer. New touch, prevailing touch. It's a global crusade, and we are praying for a day two global touch. The adults will be touched globally. The youths will be touched globally. The children will be touched globally. Congregations will be touched globally. It's what we ask that God will do. Because He said, ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. And when we knock, His promise is clear. Doors shall be opened. Jesus' name we pray. One of the fulfillment of Christ's promises, Christ's birth, is that we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us. Want to pray globally? All the enemies of the gospel, the Lord will silence their voices. All over the world, the Lord will silence their voices. Let us have voice to God in prayer. Those opposing the gospel anywhere, in Southern America, in the Caribbeans, in Europe, in Asia, in Middle East, God will silence them and allow the gospel to prevail. In Australia, in Africa, because he said this gospel of the kingdom must be preached. Therefore, let the doors be opened as God arise on our behalf, silencing those that want to turn the gospel away from those nations, from those communities, from those enclaves. In Jesus' name we pray. The haters of the gospel will not prevail, but God will prevail over them. All over the world, the two GCK, God will prevail over them. Because at the mention of the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, every knee shall bow. Let us have voice to God in prayer. God will prevail over them all. Over them all. Over them all. In all languages, all colors, cultures, in Jesus' name we pray. Want to pray? Today there will be liberation. Day two, liberation. As men who have heard by the enemy, as men who are under chains of the enemy, chain of sin, chain of drunkenness, drug, anywhere. Today, the Lord will break those chains globally. We have heard about people who are drugs addicts coming into the kingdom. We have heard about people who are chain smokers coming into the kingdom. Day two, it will multiply. Let us have voice to God in prayer. As we are praying, God is answering. As we talk to him, he's hearing us, he's performing it. For there shall be a performance. Chains of religion. Holding anyone down, any race down, any culture down, the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ will prevail. If God can set them free, they too will set them free. A as a man of God ministers. In Jesus' name we pray. There are some that are saying, we will not want this man, our Lord Jesus Christ, to reign over them. But today, God will prevail over such statements globally in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us have voice to God in prayer. As men who have avowed in their heart and in their mind, say, nothing can bring me in. Those who are backsliding, and they are saying, nothing can bring me back. Let God prevail over them all. As men whose hearts are dull of hearing, globally, they could be black, they could be white, let God prevail over them all. In Jesus' name we pray. Bible says that God will perform the mercies promised our fathers. The mercy of God will reign all over the world. Today is day two. The mercy of God will prevail. In Europe, it will prevail. Let us raise our voice to God in prayer. Lord, let your promised mercies prevail. Some cultures have gone so deep in what they are doing. Some tribal men, women have gone so deep in what they are doing. God, your promised message will reach unto them today. Promised mercies globally. As the word of God comes, in Jesus' name we pray. Want to play with the Lord today? He will remember his holy covenant. For God so loved the world, and he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but the world. Europe, but the world. America, but the world. Asia, but the world. Middle East, but the world. Africa, through him, should be saved. God, remember today your holy covenant. There's a covenant with Christ that the world will be saved through him. For it is not my will that any should perish, but that all, everywhere, today it will happen. Day two, it will happen. In the upper location, it will happen. We come to repentance. Let us raise our voice to God in prayer. Thank you for praying. Let God hear your voice.
Anymore. I will not deal that evil thing anymore. That thing can launch somebody in the eternal lake of fire, suffering in hell forever and ever. I will not continue the life of iniquity, the life of transgression, the life.
Fantastic testimony. What about a brother who testified? I gave his life to Christ 26th of August. After roaming here and there, 2022, and he shared his testimony of a changed life. And since then, God has kept him. What about a testimony? What the world of science is running helter-skelter. And because they have no solution, they are now looking for a way to eliminate it through bats, or somebody having an sickle cell, SS, And one of the global crusades, showers of blessing to be specific, the genotype moved from SS to AA. It's only God that can do that. What about the sister who testified? From B negative, God moved her to B plus. What about the sister who gave birth to twins? It's only God that can do this. And that's why we still need to raise our voice to God in praise and worship, thanking him for all these great things he's doing. It's only God that can turn the heart of man, turn the challenges of people to become a testimony. Raise your voice to God in prayer. What about the healing of a husband, the child, and the wife? Three people in a family. As I say, blessed be the name of the Lord who has visited and he has redeemed his people. Praise him for the mighty visitation. Since GK began, it has been very wonderful. There's no GCK without a testimony. And they are increasing in dimensions. What has never been, we are seeing it in our days. In Jesus' name we pray. Want us to thank him for our Father in the Lord. He is carrying the gospel with greater strength, the horn of salvation with greater strength. And it has been very amazing. Each edition, there are spectacular testimonies. Converts coming in. For God's operation in him is worth praising God for. It's worth thanking God for. That God has given us hope through him. God has given the world hope through him. Each time you look at him, it's as if the strength is increasing. The testimonies are increasing. Let us raise our voice to God in prayer as we thank God for our Father in the Lord. The authority of God is increasing every GCK. The manifestation of God is increasing every GCK. Either spoken word or being present, dissenting everywhere. People watching online are testifying. People far away in Canada testifying, in Europe testifying, in Russia testifying, far away in Asia testifying, in the Caribbean, everywhere. God's word moving in strength through his life, through his ministration. And for every other vessel who have dedicated themselves to this cause of global crusade with our Father in the Lord, let's praise God for the commitments, the consecration, the prayers, the support. In Jesus' name we pray. And today is day two. We want to ask God that, God, what will come out from the mouth of your servant, our Father in the Lord, no power will challenge it. No power will challenge it. No authority all over the world will challenge it. It will get to every destination. It will get to every life with strength. Let us raise our voice to God in prayer. His spoken word, as the scripture has confirmed, will not return void. It will return with testimony of salvation, of healing, of deliverance, of being set free from the hands of the wicked. Jesus' name we pray. Since the world began, this is wonderful. I want to pray. Today is day two. All over the world, from South America to Caribbean, to North America, to Canada, to Europe, to Russia, to Asia, to the Pacific, to Africa, the whole of Africa, want to ask God that, God, there will be a new experience today, a greater experience today. Let's raise our voice to God in prayer. All over the world, all over Africa, a new experience, day two experience, prevailing experience in South America, in the Caribbean, in North America, in Canada. Join us in prayers anywhere you are, in Europe, in Russia, in the Asian world, in the Middle East, in the islands spread all over the world, new experience. Day two, greater experience. They will experience His touch, everyone. They will experience a turning point. They will experience yieldedness. They will experience His miracles. In Jesus' name we pray. Want to pray for all languages all over the world. All tribes, colors, race, culture, ages, literate, illiterate, that the word of God will come with strength unto them today, day two. They may not have experienced anything before, but day two, God will prevail. God will prevail in every heart, in all languages, all over the world, all colors, all over the world. Starting from the Alpha location here, we raise our voice to God in prayer. New touch, prevailing touch. It's a global crusade, and we are praying for a day two global touch. The adults will be touched globally. The youths will be touched globally. The children will be touched globally. Congregations will be touched globally. It's what we ask that God will do. Because He said, ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. And when we knock, His promise is clear. Doors shall be opened. In Jesus' name we pray. One of the fulfillment of Christ's promises, Christ's birth, is that we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us. Want to pray globally? All the enemies of the gospel, the Lord will silence their voices. All over the world, the Lord will silence their voices. Let us raise our voice to God in prayer. those opposing the gospel anywhere. In Southern America, in the Caribbean, in Europe, in Asia, in Middle East. God will silence them and allow the gospel to prevail. In Australia, in Africa. Because he said, this gospel of the kingdom must be preached. Therefore, let the doors be opened as God arise on our behalf, silencing those that want to turn the gospel away from those nations, from those communities, from those enclaves. In Jesus' name we pray. The haters of the gospel will not prevail, but God will prevail over them. All over the world, the two GCK, God will prevail over them. Because at the mention of the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, every knee shall bow. Let us raise our voice to God in prayer. God will prevail over them all. Over them all, over them all. In all languages, all colors, cultures, in Jesus' name we pray. Want to pray? Today there will be liberation. Day two, liberation. As men who have heard by the enemy, as men who are under chains of the enemy, chain of sin, chain of drunkenness, drug, anywhere. Today, the Lord will break those chains globally. We have heard about people who are drugs addicts coming into the kingdom. We've heard about people who are chain smokers coming into the kingdom. Day two, it will multiply. Let us raise our voice to God in prayer. As we are praying, God is answering. As we talk to him, he's hearing us, he's performing it. But there shall be a performance. Chains of religion. Holding anyone down, any race down, any culture down, the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ will prevail. If God can set them free, they too will set them free. As a man of God ministers. In Jesus' name we pray. There are some that are saying, we not want this man, our Lord Jesus Christ, to reign over them. But today, God will prevail over such statements globally in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us raise our voice to God in prayer. as men who have avowed in their heart and in their mind, say, nothing can bring me in. Those who are backsliding, and they are saying, nothing can bring me back. Let God prevail over them all. As men whose hearts are dull of hearing, globally, they could be black, they could be white. Let God prevail over them all. In Jesus' name we pray. Bible says that God will perform the mercies promised our fathers. The mercy of God will reign all over the world. Today is day two. The mercy of God will prevail. In Europe, it will prevail. Let us raise our voice to God in prayer. Lord, let your promised mercies prevail. Some cultures have gone so deep in what they are doing. Some tribal men, women have gone so deep in what they are doing. God, your promised mercies will reach unto them today. Promised mercies globally. As the word of God comes, in Jesus' name we pray. Want to play with the Lord today? He will remember his holy covenant. For God so loved the world, and he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world, Europe, but that the world, America, but that the world, Asia, but that the world, Middle East, but that the world, Africa, through him, should be saved. God, remember today your holy covenant. There's a covenant with Christ that the world will be saved through him. For it is not my will that any should perish, but that all, everywhere, today it will happen. Day two, it will happen. In the far location, it will happen. We come to repentance. Let us have voice of God in prayer. Thank you for praying. Let God hear your voice. In Jesus' name we pray. His promise, God has a covenant. For the grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared to all men. Teaching men today that grace globally, day two, will prevail. It will prevail. Let God hear your voice. Lord, let that your promise prevail. That your covenant with us prevail. Raise your voice to God in prayer. In the white culture, in the black culture, in Southern America, there is a covenant who redeemed thy soul from all iniquity. Those that have testimony, please. You will move to the left-hand side. The interviewers are waiting for you. In Jesus' name we pray. The fruit of the global crusade, I want to pray, is that they will serve him in holiness and righteousness all the days of our lives. All over the world, the Lord will bring it to pass. That he will grant unto us that we've been delivered out of the hands of our enemy, that will happen, might serve him without fear in holiness and righteousness before him all the days of our lives. It will happen. It's happening already. It will multiply. Converts who are coming in, they will serve God in holiness and righteousness. Let us raise our voice to God in prayer. Pray in Asia, those who are coming in Europe, those who are coming in Southern America, those who are coming in Northern America, those who are coming in Africa. The result of the gospel is the same everywhere. As they come in, they will serve him without fear, in holiness and righteousness. Before him, not behind him, before him. Same results, Bible results. Raise your voice to God in prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Today, day two, all powers, the power of God will prevail over them. And as men who are stepping into the GCK arena, either here, globally, anywhere, great experience. The sick will be healed. The oppressed will be set free. The lame will rise. As we tell the Lord will confirm it. Let raise our voice as we tell God, that will be the experience today. That will be the experience today. Those who are watching online, that will be the experience today. Those who are in their homes, that will be the experience today. God will confirm his words. As it is proclaimed and pronounced, as it is declared and decreed, even upon you here today. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let us have voice as we thank him for answers to our prayers, as we bless his name, as we have spoken in his ears, so he has done unto us. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Father, thank you for answers to our prayers. All that we have brought before you, raising our voice, it cannot be otherwise. It will be confirmed fully in Jesus' name. Make the two experience of prevailing prayers a day of testimony. Sinners will come in. Those who are under one yoke or the other will be liberated. And today, globally, Lord, grant testimonies everywhere in Jesus' name. Lord, for our Father in the Lord, confirm every statement. Beyond his pronouncement, Father, do in Jesus' name. And every vessel we are going to use today, Father, confirm all that they're going to do by bringing grace to the hearers, by bringing strength to the hearers, by bringing renewal to the hearers, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you. prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. You can say a better amen. Amen. I said you can say a louder amen. Please, you have testimonies. You are just coming. Move to the left-hand side now. Our interviewers are waiting for you. No testimony is too small. Inasmuch as you have received an encounter from God, come to the left-hand side there. You will be interviewed and you give an opportunity to share your testimony with the people of God. God bless you.
Praise the Lord! Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah!
Yes, we welcome you to day two of this month's GCK titled Prevailing Prayers. And we say, as you join us, as we all rise to worship and praise God, just like Paul and Silas, as you pray, the power of the Lord will come down and solve all your problems in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hosanna. Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest.
Sing Hosanna.
Hosanna.
for the Lord Jesus Christ. Put it together. Put it together. Put it together. Praise the Lord. Amen. You may be seated, please. You are welcome to the second day of the GCK February 2024 edition. And we want to tell you that God is going to meet you in Jesus' name. Yesterday was fantastic. We are enjoying ourselves here, and I believe wherever you are in the whole world, the Lord is blessing you as well. And we pray that that blessing will continue even tonight in Jesus' name. Now open your Bibles to Psalm 81. Psalm 81, we're reading verse 10. It says, I am the Lord, thy God, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt. Open thy mouth wide, and I will fill it. The Lord says, open your mouth wide, and I will fill it. Now look at Job chapter 23. In Job chapter 23, I'm reading from verse 3. Here is Job talking. He says, oh, that I knew where I might find him, that I might come even to his seat. I will order my cause before him and fill my mouth with arguments. I would know the words which he will answer me and understand what he will say unto me. Will he plead against me with his great power? No. But he will do what? Strengthen me. He will put strength in me. He will strengthen you in Jesus' name. As you come before the Lord, he himself is calling you that you should put words inside your mouth and come to him. In Isaiah chapter 43, verse 26. Verse 26 says, put me in remembrance. Let us plead together. Declare thou that thou mayest be justified. And so prayer has been flowing since yesterday night. And I believe that tonight, prayer again will flow in Jesus' name. And we are going to get all that we are asking from the Lord. He will not deny us in Jesus' name. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you very much tonight. We praise your name. We worship you. You are a great God. You have invited us to come and plead with you and pray unto you and declare and state our points and state our cases, our cause before you. You have asked us, we should do it. Fill our mouth with arguments and come. And that as we open our mouth wide, you are going to fill it. Father, I believe that tonight, as we open our mouth wide, you will fill it in Jesus' name. And every one of us will be blessed. Globally, we'll be blessed. And all that we're asking you for in our families, in our lives, in the church, in our ministries, and for the sinners, and for people who have not known the Lord, we want them to know the Lord. Father, we believe you will answer us, and we are going to rejoice during this GCK in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for the answer. In Jesus' name, we pray. Give me a louder amen. Thank you very much. You may rise up as we sing from page 2 of our program, Sweet Hour of Prayer. Sweet Hour of Prayer that calls me from a world of care and beats me at my Father's throne, make all my wants and wishes known. In seasons of distress and grief, my soul has often found relief and oft escaped the tempter's snare. Father, I return. Sweet hour of prayer. Sweet hour of prayer. Sweet hour of prayer. Thy wings shall my petition bear. To him whose truth and faithfulness engage the waiting soul to bless. And since he bids me seek his face, believe his word, and trust his grace, I will cast on him my every care and wait for thee, sweet hour of prayer. Sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, may I thy consolation share, till from Mount Pisgah's lofty height I view my home and take my flight. This robe of flesh I will drop and rise to seize the everlasting prize and shout while passing through the air, farewell, farewell, sweet hour of prayer.
global amen. Anointed amen. We want to thank God for what he did yesterday. Today he's going to do greater thing in the name of Jesus. We want to pray for economic prosperity of nations. We want prosperity to replace poverty that is ravaging the countries. We want to put a stop to economic crisis in the land. So if you have not joined the people standing, you have to join them now. Join the warriors so that we call upon God so that he can rain prosperity, so that we can stop all these disasters. We can stop the distress in the nations. The Bible says the heart of men are failing them. Therefore, we want to call upon God. But before then, I want to read 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. It says, if my people, which are called by my name, thank God there are people of God on ground and on sight today, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face, turn from their wicked way, then I will hear from heaven and forgive their sins, and I will heal their land. The Lord will heal our land, will heal our countries, will heal our continents today in the name of Jesus. But the healing will start from the healing of wickedness, healing of corruptions, healings of wickedness in high places. That's the first set of prayer we'll pray. Then we call upon God, and it will rain prosperity. It will rain blessings. It will rain abundance. But the first thing is that we want to pray, because righteousness exalts nations. Sin is a reproach to anyone. Before we start praying, we want to enter into his gate with thanksgiving in our hearts. Let's begin to bless the name of the Lord for what he did yesterday, for divine intervention, for the salvations, for the deliverances, for what God, for miracles and healing that took place yesterday. You were not there. You see, were you not there when you see God move in his mighty way? Let's thank God for the strength. Thank God for the anointing upon the man of God. Because today is the day of greater things. Let the name of God be exalted. In Jesus' name we pray. Now I want to pray that God, let there be healing for wickedness. Let there be healing for corruptions. Globally, God, let there be healing. Let's pray and talk to the Lord. Let men become men of God. He said, if my people, let them become the people of God. Those that are not born again, let them be born again. Political leaders, let them be born again. People that are in authority, let them be born again. God begin to save their life. God begin to redeem them. God begin to deliver them. Set them free in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Now I want to make a decree like Elisha. There was a crisis, economic crisis in Samaria. But thank God for men like Elisha. He said by this time tomorrow that problem will be over. I want us to pray. Whatever economic crisis in your continent, the one in your country, the one in anywhere, let's decree prosperity. Let's prophesy prosperity. Let's pray that let there be prosperity. Instead of calamity, let there be prosperity. God, turn things around in the name of Jesus. By this time tomorrow, let all this problem be over. Let crisis be over in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. The Bible says in Daniel chapter 5, verse 12, it said, now let Daniel be called, and he will show the interpretation. Let Joseph be called. He will give us intervention. They will know what to do. Economic wizard may not know what to do, but people like Daniel will know what to do. People like Joseph will know what to do. That's why we are going to pray that all over the world, God raise men like Daniel. Raise men like Joseph. Raise advisors like them. Let's pray and talk to the Lord. God, raise people that will take us out of this tunnel. Raise men. Raise women. People that have the spirit of Holy God. People that have the spirit of wisdom. People that know what to do. Let them be called. Let them come into these situations and let it be well with all our countries, economically and globally. Let there be economic recovery in the name of Jesus. People like Daniel, we need apostles in marketplaces. Let them be called. Let them take over. Let them show what to do. Let them help the political economy in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. want to pray for rest everywhere. He said, but now, the Lord my God has given me rest on every side, so that there is neither adversary nor evil occurrence. We want to pray that God, let there be end to adversity. Let there be end to evil occurrence in all the nations and the continent of the world. I want us to pray and open our mouth that God will give us rest round about. Pray, sister, pray. Brother, let's pray. Let's call upon God. Let there be rest everywhere. Globally, let there be rest. Rest from disaster. Rest from calamity. Rest from adversity. Rest from evil occurrence. In the name of Jesus, we put an end to every evil occurrence, every accident. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray. Want to pray for this country under this economic crisis and natural disaster, that God will send redemption. The Bible says, blessed be the God of Israel, for he has visited and redeemed his people. When there is a visitation of God, there will be redemption. Let's pray that all over the world, God will visit those countries, and there will be redemption. And there's going to be salvation. And there's going to be deliverances. In the mighty name of Jesus, visit them in those places, O God, and redeem their life from destruction, and save them in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Now I want to pray for GS and other ministers for fresh anointing. The Bible says, my horn shall thou exalt like the horn of a unicorn, and I shall be anointed with fresh oil. Let's pray for fresh anointing, fresh oil. Let's pray for unction for them to function. Today is a great day. Today will be better than yesterday. We need fresh anointing for today. We need fresh oil for today. Fresh strength will come upon him and all the other ministers. They will minister as the oracle of God in the name of Jesus. They will minister with the power from on high in the name of Jesus. No man, no woman will be able to stand before him all the days of his life. The word of Samuel did not fall to the ground. His word will not fall to the ground in the name of Jesus. The word he will decree a thing, it shall be established today. There will be prevailing messages, prevailing power. It will be distributed everywhere by the powers of the Lord. Use him mightily as you have been using him before. Do greater things today, O God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Finally, you are going to pray for yourself. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 23, verse 18, for surely there is an end. Today is the end of that crisis in your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Certainly, there is going to be an end, and your expectation will not be cut off. We are going to pray that your expectation will become your manifestation. Your expectation will become your realization today. You will not be permitted to go empty-handed. I want us to pray and talk to the Lord. Pray and talk to the Lord that your expectation will become manifestation. That your expectation will become realization. I will not go empty-handed today. The Lord, you will visit me. The Lord, you will visit me. Yes, I'm going to prevail. Whatever battle that's confronting you now, you will prevail in the battle of life. You will prevail in that battle in the name of Jesus. You will have victory in the name of Jesus. Let's begin to thank God for the answers to prayer. Let's begin to thank God for the answers to prayer. Let's begin to thank him for the answers to prayer. For we have a God that answers prayer. He has done it. Let his name be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Father, we want to call upon you that you will heal our nations. You will heal our countries. Heal the nations globally of corruptions and wickedness in the name of Jesus. Therefore, we pray you will send prosperity. Instead of this crisis, let there be prosperity in Jesus' name. Jehoshaphat gave testimony that you gave him rest round about. Father, I pray all over the world, let there be rest from calamity, rest from adversity, rest from natural disasters in the name of Jesus. We commit the man of God to your hands, O God. You have been using him, you will use him mightily today. Let there be a fresh anointing, fresh unction to function in the name of Jesus. And all of us, nobody will be permitted to go empty-handed. Thank you, Lord, for the answers to our prayers. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
And everybody says, amen. Praise the Lord. Announcement. We please want to appeal to anybody
who knows the Lord has touched him, either during this GCK or in former GCK crusades, please come to my left-hand side here at the tent, under the tent there, so that we'll be able to interview you and give you opportunity to share your testimonies with the brethren. Today is the second day of this GCK titled Prevailing Prayers. And this program continues tomorrow by 0400 hours, our 5 o'clock in Nigeria. That is when we are going to have this crusade. And tomorrow morning, the youths, the campus people, and young adults, they will be having an impact program by 0700 hours GMT, that's 8 o'clock Nigerian time. And please, you will try and help to bring all our youths, all our young people. Tell them, and it's a global event, and by the grace of God, as you tell them, they will come here tomorrow. Our Father in the Lord is also going to minister to them, and it's going to be a wonderful time. Praise the Lord. And then on Monday, there will be the ministers' conference. Those who were today, they were fired up. On Monday morning is another time. And then also on Tuesday, by the same time, we had it today at Obiwali Event Center. And so when you come there, the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. We want to also say that there will be tomorrow by 3 p.m., there will be a lunch hour with Jesus, and it will be taking place at the White House. As you are coming in, there's a White House by your right hand side. As you are coming in, there is a hall on the ground floor. We'll be welcoming you there to have a time with you there. So don't forget, all those who have given their lives to Christ during this GCK, you did it yesterday. Those who are going to do that today, all of us should attend. We want to welcome our invitees, special personalities. Here in our midst is the senior pastor of the Heavenly Highway Ministry, Pastor Joseph Obuchi. Please, sir, can you rise up and greet the brethren? God bless you, sir. We also have the general overseer of Jesus Arrival Prophetic Ministry and a PFN executive, Apostle Juliet Chimaechi Ago. Can you please welcome? And then we have our state overseers of the Deeper Christian Life Ministry in the South here. We have our pastor from Delta North. Sorry, our pastor from Delta South. Our pastor from Delta South, he is in the person of Pastor Pius Idume. You're welcome, sir. And then we have our pastor from Akwa Ibom, Pastor Emmanuel Amaze. Can you greet the brethren? You're welcome, sir. And then we have our pastor from River State, and he is doubling as the coordinating overseer of the South Zone, Pastor Andrew
Osage. You're welcome, sir.